not in the shop, but in St. Mary's, in solidarity with the Gibbons family, the people asked Miss Benson, leave to rest the mortal remains of our sister Antoinette, whom a mighty God has called back to himself. At the very outset, I said my deepest condolences, you to bereaved, and pray God of Sister Antoinette in all joy, everlasting rest and peace. At this time, dear friends, I invite you to sit, and the eulogy will now be delivered.
Of whether it is called
Lord God, by your tender voice for pity, let us find in your Son comfort in our sadness, certainty in our doubt, and courage to live through this hour. Make our faith strong, Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In our simple, first reading of the Holy Scripture.
Thank you.
Death cannot destroy.
enjoy the accomplishments and the influence of a good life. Way back in the early pages of the Old Testament, there was a man named Abel, and he was the second son of Adam and Eve. And obviously, he lived thousands of years ago. We have no idea how many thousands. Yet, the New Testament says of him, although Abel is dead, he still speaks. Think of that. This man was murdered by his brother Cain. The very dawning of creation continues to have a voice, multiplied millions later. Abel's physical life was destroyed when he was apparently still a young man, but the influence of his life has never been destroyed. Continued to speak in the first century, and he speaks to us today. So my dear friends, let us hear this afternoon and encourage our hearts with this truth. There are some things that death can never touch. It can destroy the body. That destroyed the body of Adam, but it cannot cancel the accomplishment nor stop the continuing influence of a good life. Another thing that cannot do is destroy the soul. Jesus Christ once said to the disciples, said, don't be afraid of those who kill the body and can do no more. And according to Luke's Gospel, chapter 12, verse 4. And that is an accurate description of the power of death. Yes, it can kill the body, and admittedly, that is bad enough. Jesus Christ did not suggest that physical death doesn't matter, and neither do we. My dear friends, life in this flesh on this earth is terribly important. And so the loss of it always brings a degree of sorrow. It is a very sad. But it brings the bereavement. And sometimes, my friend, it depends on the symptoms of death. It is an unspeakable tragedy. But death is always better. But all the while, we need to remember that life as we now know it is only a small part of the picture. We are now in the Easter season, in the octave of Easter, which says to us Christians, it is passing through this earth, there's life beyond the grave. The resurrection is a central message of Christianity. That's why we're here today, the church. And so the power of death is limited to this small sphere of time and space. After that, life moves into a dimension where death cannot do business. Yes, my friends, it can destroy the body, but it cannot destroy the soul. And so, in closing here, do. And death cannot separate us from the love of God. Death is limited, cannot separate us from the love of God. One of the most triumphant writings in the history of literature, in the 8th chapter of Paul's letter to the Romans, he begins by saying, there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. And then toward the end, my friends, he builds this, you know, into a crescendo of joy. And here what Paul says to the Romans, and says to us here today, I am certain that neither death nor life, neither angels nor principalities, neither the present nor the future, neither life nor death, nor any creature will be able to separate us from the love of God that comes to us in Christ. So my dear friends, death has taken our dear sister and the child of the Lord. And once more, our hearts have been very sad. But remember, my dear friends, this one, Antoinette, is God to us, is still encircled by the love of God. So are we. Death can never touch or change that in any way. So my friends, with that assurance, we can join with Paul in what amounts to a mocking of death. Hear what Paul says. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? Thanks be to God who has given us the victory to our Lord Jesus Christ. The rest of our Lord, may also rest in peace. And may the soul of the faithful departed from the mercy of God rest in peace.
Cleanse her of her sins and grant her the fullness of redemption
We ask this in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We'll send your friends for collection at request of the family, collection taken up for the St. Vincent de Paul Society here at St. Mary's. risen firstborn from the dead. It is the man of sister to the Lord. The Lord may raise in peace and raise up the body on the last day. Please stand. Bow your head and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful, and you are attending the prayer of the humble. Hear your people cry out in their need and strengthen their hope. In your lasting goodness, we ask this for Christ, our Lord. Amen. Eternal rest from God to our Lord. May the peace of God, which is beyond understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and the Son of our Jesus Christ. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Peace of Christ, glory to God, glory to our lives. Hallelujah, hallelujah.